Hello everyone, thanks for joining me again in this new video. I've received a lot of questions about OxyProps colors and how to customize the color system. So in this video, we'll have a deep look at OxyProps color system. And while doing this, we will discuss about CSS custom properties and the way of properly using them. Because something important to keep in mind is that CSS custom properties are also called CSS variables and they are not called CSS constants. And that's because it's very important to think of them as variables, which values can be dynamic and can be reassigned depending on the context. And that's exactly what OxyProps color system does. So let's have a look at it. And to start with, let's go to our dashboard. So depending on when you watch this video, your dashboard may look different than mine. This is the development version, and I'm still running some tests before releasing this version. But a lot of people ask me about the possibility to define custom colors. And that's why you can see that I have for each of the colors here a custom value at the bottom, and we will see those custom values a bit later. But to start with, I did pick colors from the predefined color sets offered by OxyProps. So I did set my canvas color to slate, my brand color to indigo, my links color to grape, and my visited link color to teal. At the bottom of my dashboard, I have a preview of my color scheme, and I can see all color variations or color shades available for each of the logical colors. In OxyProps, canvas, brand, links, and visited are called logical colors. When you choose a named color for each of the logical colors, for example indigo, the one I can see here, is the fifth shade, the middle shade of the color swatch. Same for grape, that's grape 5, and here that's teal 5. They are all defined with the fifth shade as a reference, and then we have 5 shades available on each side. So from canvas 5, going towards black, I have 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And going towards white, I have 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. And then for each one, you have transparencies available. You will see that we can do anything for transparency, but as an example, transparencies are shown based on the 9th shade and with opacities ranging from 5% for the very low opacity to 95%. And we have the same for the brand, links, and visited color swatch. So that's enough for this introduction, and let's jump into Oxygen Builder. In a blank page, the first thing I want to show you is that as I did activate, okay, let's go back to the dashboard. I did activate this option, and actually this is activated by default when you install OxyProps. So this option, make colors available as global colors. And back in the builder, first time you run Oxygen Builder with this option activated, OxyProps will create global color sets. And now we have 3 of them for the logical colors, the custom palette, and the color palette. These color sets will be available as global colors, of course, for each element. And if we have a look inside it, we see that OxyProps did register each available shade for each named color in the OxyProps preset colors as global colors. So for example, I will find my indigo from indigo 0 to indigo 10. And this for each of the 18 named colors and the 9 canvas colors. And for the logical colors, OxyProps did register my brand color, my link visited, my text 1, text 2, and my 4 surfaces colors. Let's add an element. So let's add a section. And in this section, let's add a heading. And I want to define my heading color. So I select the element. And we have 3 possibilities to define the color. The first one we just saw is to use global colors that were registered. And from the settings, I did define my brand color to be indigo. And let's say I want my text to be my brand color. I click in the Oxygen panel on the color picker, and you see that the 3 color sets are available, the logical one, the custom one, and the full color palette. So what are the differences between those different color sets? Let's start by the OxyProps color palette, where all 11 shades of each named colors are made available. You can think of these colors as constants. If I come here and I select, for example, my indigo 5, which I did define as my brand color, and that I set my text color to be my indigo 5, my text will always be indigo 5, regardless of the color scheme or the light and dark mode. We'll see this in a minute. Now let's duplicate this heading, remove the global color, and let's have a look at the second way we have to pick the color, which is by assigning a variable. So in OxyProps, we have a handy context menu. You right click on the color field and you have all the OxyProps logical colors available. You cannot assign with the context menu every single shade of every single named color. That would be a mess, an extremely huge context menu. So I made the choice to restrict it to logical colors. This doesn't mean that you cannot use the full color selection, because you can type var to call the custom property and then double dash o dash indigo 5 if I want my indigo 5 and close the bracket. And we get the same result, but this one was defined using a global color, the global color itself being linked to the custom property. And this one is styled directly using the custom property. Let's duplicate it once again, clear the field. And the third way to style my text is to use a utility class o-text-indigo-5. And what this class does is that it assigns the indigo 5 custom property to the color property of the element. So these are the three ways to assign colors. If I go to my section and want to assign a background color, here again, I can assign, for example, my indigo 10 to the background, but I could also assign the var dash dash o dash indigo 10, or assign the class o-bg-indigo-10. Again, three ways of assigning colors. All named colors are made available to be used this way in the OxyProps framework, but you need to keep in mind that assigning colors this way is similar to using constants, and that the color will be constant whatever the color scheme or the color mode. Maybe that's what you want, maybe that's not what you want. To illustrate that, I will duplicate the section and remove the styling to each element. And I will add a section at the top, and let's add a light and dark toggle. Let's align it to the right. Let's remove padding on this section with the class o-sec-pad-none. Perfect, so now we have our light and dark mode toggle, and I will style my headings, first using a global color, but this time I will use my logical color for my brand. For the second one, I will use the custom prop, double dash o dash brand. For the third one, I will use the class o dash text dash brand. And for my section, I will set my background color to my surface one. Let's save and have a look at the front end. And when we switch between light and dark mode, we see that the first section that was styled with the directly named color from the color palette is constant, and the second one adapts to light and dark mode. We are now in light mode, so the section background uses the light version of my surface one, and the text here uses a darker version of my brand color. And when I switch back to dark mode, I have the dark version of my surface one and a lighter version of my brand color. So the system adjusts and in dark mode chooses a lighter shade of my brand color, and in light mode chooses a darker shade of my brand color. And this is automatic in order to keep enough contrast and readability for our user. Moreover, if I go back to my dashboard and change my brand color from indigo to maybe jade, let's save. And back to my front end, if I refresh, the first section remains indigo, as we could expect, but the second section, styled with logical colors, did adjust to my new selected brand color. And this is because we styled it with logical custom properties that we can think of as variable, and that the variable value is reassigned dynamically. So we did define Jade as our brand color. We are in dark mode version of our website, and our heading is assigned the lighter version of our brand color to accommodate contrast on the dark background. And going back to the light version, it's now assigned the darker version of our brand color to accommodate the light background. Now let's go back to the editor, get rid of this section. So we now have only the section styled with the logical color. Let's refresh the builder to have our latest selection. So we have seen that OxyProps uses a darker shade of the brand color for light mode, a lighter shade for dark mode. But what if I want an even darker or an even lighter shade on my website? Well, this is possible. And what you need to do is to activate this option, the custom color scheme style sheet from your dashboard. And once this option is activated, you will find in Oxygen Builder style sheets an OxyProps folder, and within this OxyProps folder, an OxyProps theme style sheet. And in this style sheet, everything is commented by default, but here I did uncomment part of it. So let's work only on the brand color. So here I'm on the light mode. And once again, let's think about our custom properties as variable and not as constants. This one is the custom property that defines our brand color for light mode, and we can assign it whatever value we want. So by default, it uses the user brand, and this is the shade. If I want something even darker, I can go with user brand 9, for example. Don't forget to change the HSL version of it also, so we can use transparencies and opacities. And let's change also the hover version of it to 7, for example. And now let's go to the dark mode, uncomment the brand, and here if I want a darker version also, let's go to 5, 5 and 3. Let's collapse the editor, save, and have a look at our front end, refresh, and here we are with the very dark version of our brand color. And going to the dark mode, we are now using the 5th shade of the color. So maybe this one is too dark, I want it much lighter. So let's change that and go to 6, for example. Here we are, save and refresh. And this is light mode and this is dark mode. Now that we have seen how to adjust which shade we want to use for each color scheme, and by the way, we did act on the light and dark schemes, but you can also do the same for the dim, the low contrast one, the light colorful scheme, and the dark colorful scheme. All these are properties used by the schemes that are fully customizable from this style sheet. But imagine I'm working on a client project and the client has strictly defined brand colors, and my client brand colors is not available as a default color from OxyProps presets. Well, now you will be able to define a completely custom color reference for each of the logical colors. So I will choose custom as a brand color, and by clicking on the color sample, I access a color picker, and from the color picker, I can define a completely custom color, either from the color picker or as an RGB, HSL or Xcode. So let's say that I want my brand color to be this brown. I want my canvas color to be something similar, but much more desaturated. I want my links to be a bright red, and I want my visited links to be a desaturated red. Let's save. And now my color scheme has switched to my custom colors with my custom brand, link, visited, and canvas colors. And if I go back to my front-end with my sample page and I refresh, it should now use my custom colors. This is the light version using my custom colors, and this is the dark version using my custom colors. From the dashboard, we can see that the color we picked from the color picker defines the reference color, the shade number 5, and that OxyProps automatically generated the other shades, 5 shades towards full black and 5 shades towards full white. 0 and 10 are not full white and full black. They are the last step just before full white and full black. And the same happens for my link color, my visited color, and my canvas color. And here again, I can decide that I want my brand color to be the 7th shade in light mode and the 4th shade in dark mode. So I go to my style sheet and change it to whatever I want. So 7 for the light mode, 4 for the dark mode. Let's save. I didn't refresh the builder, so it doesn't reflect my last preferences, but going to the front end, let's refresh. And it's now using 4th shade in dark mode and 7th shade in light mode. We can check by inspecting. Okay, so let's make it bigger. You see that our headline is set to our brand custom property. We can see that our brand custom property is set to our brand light because we are in light mode, and that our brand light is set to our user brand 7 that we just set in the style sheet. Now let's go to dark mode. And in dark mode, we see that our headline still is set to our O-brand custom property. But this time, O-brand was reassigned the brand dark value, and our brand dark value is set to our user brand 4 that we just set in the style sheet. And this is how you can choose to use preset colors or custom colors with OxyProps, how you can redefine which shade to use in light mode, in dark mode, in dim mode, and how to use custom colors. It's not yet available, but the plugin update will be released very soon to define your own custom color as a reference and have OxyProps powerful color system create the other shades and apply it dynamically where needed. If you enjoyed the video, please give me a thumbs up, consider subscribing to the channel, and I'll see you in the next video.